Red Giant Looks is a powerful tool that you can use to create the look for your movies, music videos, CG renders, and many more. It is very flexible and easy to use. There are tons of grading and look development tools and customizable presets that can help you to get started with your color grading. However, there is this one thing, one very important thing that you need to do to get the full experience and benefit of Red Giant Looks. You will need to set up the color management before developing your looks. Well, although it may sound scary, the process is very simple. You will only need to tell Looks what camera you are using to capture the image, or what color space you are using to render the image, and what display that you are planning to view your image on. That's it. It is that simple. So, for example, if you have clips coming from an ARRI camera, simply select ARRI Lock C in the In and Out Color Space dropdown, and if you have Sony images, then select Sony S-Log3. Or if you are working with a color management framework like ACES in DaVinci Resolve, you can either select ACES CCT or ACES CC. Just make sure that it matches with your Resolve settings. By the way, we've discussed about setting up ACES and Looks in the previous video. I'll provide the link in the description. So if you missed that, go and check that video out. Bear in mind though, that Looks by default will always give you back the color space that you are fitting it with. If you select ACES CCT in the dropdown, by default, it will give you ACES CCT back at the output. The same with ARRI Lock C. Selecting ARRI Lock C will inform Looks that you have a Lock C clip as an input and you want to have Lock C back at the output. If you want to change this behavior and change the output, for example, if you want your ARRI Lock C clip to be transformed into the display space that your screen can fully reproduce like Rec. 709 or sRGB, then select ARRI Lock C in the dropdown and open the dropdown again, then select Custom. Then in the Color Management tab, disable the same as input button. Well, there will be time where you won't see your camera listed in this in/out color space dropdown, and this is the case where you want to use custom. As we already see before, selecting custom will open the full color management tab. And here, you can select the color management to suit your workflow. So for example, if you have clips coming from red camera, you can select custom and leave the color mode to OpenColorIO-ACES. And using OpenColorIO-ACES mode means that we will use ACES Transform to correctly map our image from the camera color space to the display color space where we want to see our image. So we can actually just focus on the fun stuff, developing the looks that we want to see and leave the technical transformation to ACES. Select input RWG RedLock 3G10 and set the output to Rec. 709. There is also this neat preview icon on the top. Make sure to set it to the same type to your output color space. You can use this button to see the lock state of your image and the final state of your image within the selected output color space or the color space that your display is using. So now, by previewing our final stage of our image, we can monitor the changes we made on our grade. By default, Looks input and output are set to Rec. 709. We know that Rec. 709 images are not the best one when it comes to color grading. You probably want to have log or raw files when grading. But using Magic Bullet Looks, you can still do some magic with your color grading for those images that are already in the display space, like 709 or sRGB. So if you only have sRGB or Rec. 709 images to play with, don't sweat, drop in Looks and start tweaking the grade. The color management part will be taken care of automatically by Magic Bullet Looks. You can still make the best out of your Rec. 709 images using Red Giant Looks. Happy grading with Red Giant Looks, and please tag us in your social media post the next time you create something cool with Looks.